Today, we're going to learn how to insert keys into a B tree. This is more complicated than inserting into a binary tree, as we must maintain the properties of a B tree. Namely, all leaves have the same depth, and a node may contain at most 2 times T minus 1 keys. To accommodate this, when we have a full node, we must split the node into two, each having T minus 1 keys. We move the median key into the parent node. Let's take a look at an example. Assume T is 3. This means that we can have at most 5 keys in a node. Here's a node A with 5 keys, along with its parent, which is the root. We want to insert an additional key with the value of 60. We would insert the key into node A, but as you can see, it has 5 keys and is full. We split A into 2 nodes and move the median value, 63, into the parent. However, what happens when the parent is full? In this situation, we wouldn't be able to insert the median into the parent because it already has 5 keys. To prevent against this, as we travel down the tree, we preemptively split full nodes that we encounter. That way we can insert a key in a single pass. To help us do this, we're going to create a method that splits a child node. Let's take a look at that code. It takes a non-full internal node, x, and the index of a full child, I. The method splits the child into two nodes and updates x so that it has a pointer to the new child. We first get a pointer to the full child we're going to split, which will be y. We create a new node called z and add z to x's list of children. We then insert the median key of y into x. This is the key with a value of 63. We split y's keys apart into both y and z, except the median, which just moved up to the parent. Finally, if y is not a leaf node, we reassign y's children to both y and z. I won't show this step in the visualization. This covers split child, which we'll use in our insert method. Let's take a look at that now. Here's the code for insert. We first need to check the root to see if it's full. If it is, we create a new empty node and add it to the B tree, and the height of the tree grows by 1. We set the tree's root to the new node. We then add the old root as a child of the new root. We call split child, which splits the old root into two nodes. Finally, we call a new method, insert non-full, which we'll cover in a bit. If the root is not full, we simply call insert non-full. Let's look at that code now. Notice there are two main sections based on whether the node is a leaf. We insert the key into a leaf, as shown here. I'm going to only show the top part of the code for now, and let's walk through an example. We have the node on the right, which is a leaf. We want to insert the key of 26 into this node. We set I equal to the length of the keys minus 1, which is 3. We append a null key to the end of the array, which I'll mark by x. We then iterate through the keys until we find the correct spot for 26. I'll let the visual play without voiceover. Let's take a look at the rest of the code, where the node is not a leaf. Let's say we want to insert 70. We first need to determine the subtree in which 70 belongs. We do this by scanning the keys in the node. In this case, the rightmost child is the subtree in which 70 belongs. I won't show it, but if the child is full, we first split it. We then call insert non-full again, and do this recursively until we reach a leaf. Again, here's the complete insert non-full code. The entire code for insert is on my GitHub and linked in the description. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.